I saw a tweet today that said, if the people you've hired don't occasionally fight your ideas, you've hired poorly. My reply to that is that if you don't encourage people to fight your ideas, you're a poor leader. Welcome back to Dan on Dev, where we really focus on hacking software engineering leadership. Today's episode, we are titled The Ted Lasso Way, and we will be explaining why and how Ted Lasso loops into this conversation here in a minute. But the key thing here that I want to talk about, and this one is near and dear to my heart, because this is crucial if you want to have an environment where innovation really takes place. And that is around the topic of bringing in ideas and allowing ideas to foster. Great ideas can come from anybody on your team. Many of you are wondering, why are we not seeing that in our organization? Why do we not see ideas coming from everybody? Coming from every, they could be coming from the janitor as far as I'm concerned. Where are these ideas coming from? It is important to foster a space where ideas come in. I was on Twitter today, and this is actually part, this like fed really perfectly into the topic. Matt Weinzig is brilliant. He does a bunch of really great stuff. He's very active on Twitter, and he put this tweet out today, and it says, if the people you've hired don't occasionally fight your ideas, you've hired poorly. And I saw that, and I appreciated the sentiment behind it. What I don't know that I agreed with is the idea that it's just about who you hire. That is a piece of it. My reply to this is that if you don't encourage the behavior, you're a poor leader. And the reason I focus on this a lot is because you must encourage. You have to encourage anybody and everybody on your team to bring in ideas. I was looking back on his tweet and other replies, and I saw this other one here that from Phoebe from Fembot that said, or you've created a culture where it's discouraged or unsafe to do so. If you do not actively encourage, this will often happen. You will implicitly discourage. Sometimes we think about the discouragement in the model of like shooting down somebody's idea. And that may happen. You may have explicit discouragement. And I've seen that plenty. I've seen plenty of times where in an organization, the people who are the naysayers or the ones that are constantly challenging or arguing, they aren't there anymore. And maybe because they were actually driven out, but it could be that they left because they didn't feel appreciated. You will see that a lot. You have to actively encourage the debate and the conversation. You have to bring that out of people. Sometimes it will be a lot more subtle. Somebody wants to share an idea. They may indicate that, you know, you may see them across the meeting room, you know, a little squirmy, trying to figure out how to share this idea. And if you're not watching for that, and you're not looking to see where this idea may come from and then pull it out of somebody, then that idea could get lost. And that person's gonna be sad they never shared it, right? If they're not the boldest person. So this kind of loops back to Ted Lasso. It started making me think about episode 3 of the series. So if you haven't watched, Ted Lasso is a football coach actually in the U.S. Somehow he ends up getting recruited to be a soccer coach for a team in the U.K. And he doesn't really know the game. And he's actually a very good example of what a lot of managers really ought to think of themselves as. He got in there and he didn't know really anything about soccer. Didn't understand the rules. When you go into a new organization, if you're a leader and you go into a new organization, you ought to basically try to shut down your ego and listen and be in that listening mode and trying to figure out how things work before you start implementing your own ideas. So that's kind of an aside. But anyway, he comes in, but what's fantastic about him is he is humble about it. He brings in somebody that brings along one of his coaches that really understands soccer and uses that experience, that knowledge, and honors that and respects it and uses it. But what he also is very open to other ideas. So there's a kit man. There's a guy who is the equipment boy is in the room. And what we see here, and we're going to show this clip, Ted Lasso, first off, recognizes that there's a problem. There's a problem with his product.
Going over here, going over that way. There's something that's coming all the way down.
Crystal Palace kicked our booties last week.
Mm-hmm.
And this here is our current offense that we are running. And I think it stinks!
Okay, right here, he's recognized that there's the problem. And the next thing he's going to do is open up the problem to everybody else to help contribute.
Now look, our whole offense right now is all give and go. Give the ball to Jamie and everyone else can go to hell. So I am officially on the prowl for any new ideas, you hear?
Right here, you see Nate. And if you've seen the series, you've probably seen to the end, Nate betrays him. So let's just ignore all of that for a minute, okay? But this is the beginning. This is the genesis of all of this. But Nate is fidgety here. He's that person across the meeting room that's fidgety, who wants to say something. Maybe he's not bold enough. But what's fantastic about the way Ted handles the situation is he wants to draw it out of the person. And he wants to help encourage this. He wants to encourage Nate to share.
You got something, Nate?
No. God, no. Never mind. I'm sorry.
Come on now. You're one of us. Let's go. Fire away. What do you got?
Okay. Right.
So again, Nate's very hesitant. He's like, come on. Let's bring it in. Let's talk. Tell me your idea. Right? That's what you need to be able to do. And sometimes you have to make it a little fun.
Okay, right. In the pocket. It's just something that I thought of. Sorry. Oh, not that one. It's not very, even very good. It's probably really bad. You know what? It's embarrassing even.
Sorry, Nate. I have a real tricky time hearing folks that don't believe in themselves. So I'm gonna ask you real quick again. Do you think this idea will work?
Yeah, I do.
Whoa! Why are you screaming at us, Nate? We're right here. All right, come on now. Walk us through it.
Okay, so I thought if we started the attack on the wing, Jamie could run through near side. Then when the defense follows, Sam could fill his spot.
So use Jamie as a decoy?
No.
They even recognize that it is an interesting proposition. This is actually goes against what you would expect the team to want to do. They've got their star player, Jamie, that he's now saying he's basically going to turn it into a decoy. Right? So it's an unconventional solution that he's bringing out, and he's still getting nervous.
But they follow through.
Let's give it a shot.
What, you gonna use my play?
Okay, here we go. Sam lays it for Dixon. Okay, nice touch. Switch to bumper catch. Jamie decoys through. Sam wide open. There it is. Nice play, Nate. How you feel?
Yeah, just don't know. There's so many new feelings, right? Yeah.
Look at that. It's amazing. You've now taken somebody who was nervous and didn't want to share or was nervous about sharing. You've drawn it out of them. You let them see it. And this is actually important. Sometimes you'll get an idea. Not every idea is going to be great, okay? But if you do get the idea from somebody, it is also very critical for them to have the opportunity to see the execution, to see it play out. And this is easy to do with software to some degree. There's plenty of times where you'll create a solution, solve a problem, the engineers will go do it, and then you'll get a build that actually has the feature, and you can go back to the person and say, hey, look, we've done it. Let's see how this actually runs. I like to also go hook up some analytics and see how it actually performs, get some real quality results. But the key thing here is that you have to actively encourage. You have to encourage everybody to share. You have to draw it out of them. And to me, if you don't, you're not being a good leader. Go be a good leader.